Good day, everyone, and welcome to another chapter of a devotional message of Vertical Connection. My name is Brother Dwight, and today I want to share the story of the new backpack. One day, a man is excited because he will be having his first hiking trip. For this hiking trip, he is expected to walk for many hours just to reach the top of the mountain. For that reason, he decided to buy the best new backpack he could ever found in the market. Now, this backpack has a lot of interesting features. It was so light that you can lift it up with one finger. It has a unique design to not to strain your shoulder muscles, and more extra zippers for easy access and storage. With that said, this new backpack could definitely help him. About ready to go, he filled his new backpack with extra clothes, some gadgets, and few more things that he wants to carry and try it on. Surely, it was fine and he could carry the load easily enough. Now, before he even began climbing the mountain, one of the guides asked him this: "Could I carry the backpack for you?" And he replied, "No thanks, I'm fine," thinking that if someone will carry his new backpack, it will just get dirty and might be broken. So they started off the long walk, and for sure, his new backpack worked nicely. But suddenly, he noticed that the longer they walked, his new backpack started to feel heavier and heavier and heavier. "Those things that I pack weren't so heavy when I try it at home," he said to himself. Now, with the hot sun beating on their heads, walking up one hill and down to another cliff to climb, and another steep curve to pass by, everyone is exhausted, and there was no one to offer help with his own new backpack. The man started to feel worried and afraid because he would never make it on the top. Why? Because he could no longer had the strength to carry his new backpack. Still over 2 more hours to reach at the top. Now feeling wasted and exhausted, suddenly, the guide whom he spoke with before suddenly appeared and now riding on a horse asked him the same question again, offering if he wants to carry his new backpack for him. Finally, without any hesitation, he gave his new backpack and he continued to walk without any more burdens on his shoulder. End of the story. Now, what is the moral lesson of the story? Ano po ba ang matututunan natin sa istoryang ito na pwede po natin gamitin sa ating pang-araw-araw na ginagawa? Now, as we can see, the new backpack he bought represents the best thing that money could buy and the best thing the world can offer to help him carry all the things that he wants to carry. And yet, it could not help him ease the load from being heavy when being carried in the long run. Now, this represents the baggage of sin we carry in our lives. This world is trying to trick us, offering things to make sin look attractive and make it look like not a big deal. Parang magaang lang pala, parang masarap sa una, parang konting kasalanan lang yan, kapatid. But always remember this. No matter how light the load of sin right now you are doing, it will get heavier the longer you carry it yourself. Amen. Pero ang Panginoon po may solusyon. On Hebrew 9:28 says, "So Christ was sacrificed once to take away the sins of many, and he will appear a second time, not to bear sin, but to bring salvation to those who are patiently waiting for him." Amen. So clearly, the verse teaches us that our Lord Jesus Christ came to the world to free us all on the sin we carry in our lives. And surely, he will return to bring salvation on those who are patiently waiting for him. Amen. And besides po, he even encouraged us to come to him. All of us who have a heavy burden, and he will give us rest. Matthew 11:28. Amen. So, libre po ito at hindi nyo po kailangang magbayad. Secondly, the man has one goal. Tama po ba? To make it at the top of the mountain. Now, the problem is, as he walks through along the challenges going to the mountain, these baggages that he carry gave him a hard time reaching his goals. Now, our God, as a loving Father, when He sees us reaching our goal, that would make Him feel happy and proud as well. Amen po ba? But, take note of it. Our Lord Jesus Christ is not offering instant help to achieve our goals. Hindi po yan parang magic na kapag sinabi mo na, Lord, gusto kong pumunta sa taas. Pamagic ka niyang ganun, nandun ka na sa taas. Hindi po ganun, mag-work ang Panginoon. But instead, He would let us walk through all the challenges in our life while, on the other hand, He is the one carrying all the baggages that will hinder us reaching our goals. Amen po ba? Parang sa Tagalog po, ganito yan eh. Sabi ng Panginoon sa'yo, anak, alam ko ang mithiin mo sa buhay. Sige, susuportahan kita. Kaya mo yan. Pero para hindi ka na mahirapan, ibigay mo na sa akin lahat ng pasanin mo. Dadalin ko na para nang sa ganon nang lumakad ka at nang maabot mo ang gusto mong marating nang walang alinlangan. Amen? So all we need to do right now is to trust and believe the Lord that He will take care all our worries, all our burdens, and all the things na nagpapabigat sa ating mga puso. So I hope we learned something new today, and may we remember that God is here waiting for us to take away our burdens. God bless us all, and let us pray. Lord, your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. May the things that we have shared dwell in our hearts and steer us to action. This we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. So I hope you feel the presence of our Lord today, and I also encourage you to subscribe and share our channel and hit po the notification button para updated po kayo sa mga susunod pang videos na aming gagawin. Salamat po.